Hey, Chrissy Moore here with morefitness.com, and today I have a warrior workout. We're going to be doing 10 rounds. We're going to be skipping in between each weighted exercise, and the only other piece of equipment besides a rope you will need is going to be your sandbag. If you don't have a sandbag, you can use dumbbells, you can use a backpack and throw a bag or two of rice in it. You can do your own, like, do-it-yourself sandbag, which that always works perfectly. But you will need some sort of weight to get the most out of your workout. You can set your timers to 10 second rest, 50 seconds of work, and 10 rounds. You will try to repeat this 3 times. If you're a beginner, shoot for 1 to 2, intermediate 2 to 3, advanced 3 or more. If you complete it 3 times, it's gonna be 30 minutes. So I'm gonna go through it once with you now, and then you can just go right back to the beginning to start it over again for your second, third round or whatnot. Okay, we will be starting with rope skipping, and I'll guide you along. You can look at the bottom below for the list of exercises, and follow along, and we will begin. And again, don't hate on my skipping. As I told you, I'm somewhat of an amateur. Okay, 10 seconds of rest, right into the rope skip, and then we're gonna be following it by a push-up, clean and press with a bag, okay? 3, 2, and 1. Okay, 50 seconds is kind of a long time for me to skip, but, and not mess up. So, that's the way it's gonna be. Chill out. I just taped one of the burnouts, another burnout. So, I am definitely getting my set of cardio and strength today. That's all good. Trying to bring you guys some good workouts. Also trying to concentrate so I don't screw the rope skipping up. I feel like when I think about it too much is when I tend to screw it up. Oh my lord! Wow, okay, 10 seconds and we're gonna be going right in to push up, clean, and press. Okay? Again, push up down. Okay, turn it over. Wasn't that prepared for this. Push up. Push up. Go to your knees for these if you need to. Push up. You want to protect your back when you're coming up. So make sure you're engaging your abdominals here, picking up the weight. Alternative, step it back. Push up. Bring it in. Bring it up. Press. Even further, step it back. Go to your knees and do a push up. Okay, we're going back to the rope skip. Oh my lord! Oh my goodness! Oh my gosh! All right, let's just keep it to the good old up and down, right? Listen, I'm not trying to do any tricks here. You know what I'm saying? All right. Breathe. We're gonna be lunging next. Taking the bag. We're lunging with a tricep extension. Okay? So I'm putting the bag in the back. I'm doing a reverse lunge. Up, back, down. Up, back down. Keep your elbows facing up, facing straight ahead. Try to keep them as close to your ears as possible. If you have a really heavy sandbag, then you might find that bringing the weight overhead is going to be tough.
You can go down to a lighter weight and use your dumbbell for this one. Again, you want to make sure your abdominals are engaged. Each time, you extend up and down. 3 seconds, two, and we're going right into the rope skip.
Sorry about the telephone ringing. I don't know who that was. Okay. Someone from New Jersey. It's always someone from New Jersey, right? Listen, I can make jokes about New Jersey because I live in New Jersey, okay? We're going. Again, you know, if you're all new to your beginner, you can take out a lot of the weight here. All right, and just kind of get the squats in, get the lunges in. You can always do the exercises that require upper body movements, but do them without weight. That's fun too. Just get moving. We're gonna do a squat and press next. My towel across the room. Not well planned. Not well planned. Okay, here we go. Down, press. Down, down, press it up. Press it up. Doing a side profile shot for you guys so you can see how my knees are not going to be on the toe. When I'm down in this position, I can pick my toes up out of my sneaker. Okay, all that weight is in your heel. I see so many people doing squats and they're like dipping forward like this, which is so bad for you. So bad for your knees, so bad for your back and your core. Ugh. Make sure your abs are nice and tight. All right. Back to your rope. All right. The sweat is dripping off my chin like I have a goatee. Okay, it feels like I have a goatee right now. Okay. Trying to keep this light on my toes. I think part of the reason why I hated skipping rope for a long time is because I had the worst, cheapest rope you buy. And it would get tangled. And it was so extremely long. So I'm 5'2". Not that tall. No jokes. Okay? And I bought these ropes that were so long and I never really tied them. But there's like a, you know, rhyme and reason to the length of rope you should be using to your height. All right, this one, push up. Back drop, or back drag, in and out of that. Push up, back drag, in and out of that. Okay, push up, drag your back. Core nice and tight, in and out. Push up, back drag, in and out. Push up, back drag, in and out. Back drag, in and out. Push up, back drag. Woo! In and out. Push up, back drag. In and out. Push up, back drag. In and out. Push up. Oh my gosh. Okay, back to your rope skipping. You guys, we're almost finished. Okay, after this, we have one more exercise after the skipping rope. Okay? It's your last time skipping. Alright? We're almost at 10 minutes. Isn't that crazy? Time feels fast when you're doing something. I love rep workouts, but I do love my time workouts. feel like they go by pretty quick. Now, especially if you know, okay, doing this for 45 seconds, 50 seconds, anybody can do anything for that period of time. All right, guys, we got bear hug, power squat. Power squats are these, okay? You're gonna be holding the bag. Hold it kind of high, especially if you're short like me, so you can get your leg movement in, okay? Shoulders and head are up, okay? You don't want to be doing this. Keep it up. You can hold it tighter if you want to. My bag weighs about 25, 30 pounds. You want to keep this squat position the whole time. You don't want to be standing up. You want to keep the squat position. 10 seconds. Breathe. 3, 2, and 1. Oh my goodness. Okay guys, that was one round. So I want you to go back to the beginning and I want you to complete it for 2 more rounds. So again, 1 round, 1 to 2 rounds if you're a beginner, 2 to 3 if you're intermediate, 3 or more if you're advanced. 1 round will take you about 10 minutes, and so then 3 rounds will take you about 30 minutes. I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure to check out my YouTube channel for more workouts and burnouts, and catch me on dailyhit.com, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.